back again at Villa Gordon. We got some safes this time that we're looking for. But here's the thing. These safes, in rain or water, will trigger an alarm. And we've got six things we need to get rid of, by the look of it. So we need to dump them in water. But then surely if we dump the first one in water, the alarm's going to go off. So surely we're going to need to move them all close to water before we do any dumping. Sounds like a pain in this mission. TBH. That's a nice car. We'll probably need it at some point, so let's just move it out of the way for safety. Now, this would be why the TV was telling us, oh, if you've got anything that you need to move in the rain, maybe you can improvise some sort of covered truck. It wants us to find, like, big truck or something, and then throw a bunch of planks on it. Or something along those lines. So, we're not even in the correct building here. It's this one over here. I've upgraded the bombs. Yeah, that's a big boom. I like a lot. Ah, we're in his bedroom, are we? There's a safe. Good. And it can be picked up quite comfortably. Good. So I could get it close to the water over there, perhaps, and then toss it in. But then... Right, we know where it is, at least. Where are the rest? There's one down there, one there. Because if I can get them all in one place, then life becomes pretty great. But for that, we'd need some sort of big vehicle, big construction vehicle. Let's see if this safe's up to anything exciting. Nope, it's just sat there again. So none of them are alarmed, but they can't be moved without cover. Yeah, supercars in the rain are fun. Now, there we go. Our old friend Big Truck is sticking around, and that's useful. Wait a minute, could we? No, these are too fragile, aren't they? I could pick one up with a crane, but they just fall apart the minute you do anything with them. Now, whereabouts is our safe? This one's optional, but we'll get it anyway, I imagine. Ah, she blows. So let's bring her over here for a moment. Right, that's a floor. We'll soon get rid of that. And now we can see our truck. Perfect. So if we park up here, the truck should be undercover. At least the back of the truck should be undercover. She should be able to plonk this in it. Good. That seems to work. Now if we can plonk something on top, like say, planks, then we might be able to keep it dry. I don't know how good this has to be. If it has to cover literally every inch of the safe, then that could be fiddly and awkward. That looks alright. Let's try it. It's forgiving by the look of it. That is really good news. Now, where might we want to take them all? Over there somewhere? Maybe. Oh, there's another truck over there, even better. So it's not like I need to grab them all into one truck. And there was even a safe in here, wasn't there? Perfect. I'll snatch you up and bring you over to our truck. Maybe. Have I just broken the stair lift? The lift here? Yes. Annoying. I was going to use that. Maybe just bring over a shelf of some sort. Hop. Grab the old safe. Lift her up. And fall down again. Maybe if we stand in the truck. There we go. But now we still do have the issue of getting back into... Well, we've got the issue of getting onto the truck so we can plank up. That's safe. Make our own platforms, that's good. We've got room for a third safe in this truck. If we want to be really professional about things. And that does sound like the sort of thing we would do, right? Now let's see if that's sufficiently covered. Rain detected. It's not covered. How long have I got until the alarm goes off? Not long. It's nice that it gives you some margin for error though. I like that. So where was rain detected? On that bit? Probably that bit. Excellent. So yeah, this mission could have been the worst thing in the world if it was more finicky. But it seems like it isn't. And thus, I like it. I like it. It's pretty cool. Now, let's leave this here for now. Because I want to have a look in this here room. Was that necessary? Door might have been unlocked anyway. Don't care. Because there's a safe there. But... we can also carry this safe, I imagine. It's heavy, but we can carry it. Because this is all covered up nicely. And we did see that there was another safe over here, so... it feels like it would make sense to bring these two together. We're just scraping it across the floor there. Cleaner's gonna go mad when they see that. Although I imagine Gordon Wu's cleaner at this point is just used to all sorts of nonsense. Holes in the floor? Yeah, it's just standard Wu manner things. No, it's the other one on the ground level. It might have been. Oops. Oops! I panicked and shot off the button. Never mind. Right, I might have broken this elevator for good. Now, where are you safe? You're not even in here. Are you on the third floor again? Is this more third floor nonsense? No, were you on the second floor and I just didn't see... Oh no, there you are. Heavy safe. Yeah, we can still move it. It's just a bit heavy is all. What happens though if we bomb it? Not a lot, because these safes are bomb proof, right? So it should just make its way to ground level. Yes. With a bit of assistance, perhaps. And there we go, we're all at ground level together. What fun. We're not even at ground level yet, this is like one above ground level. So let's keep going. And where is that going to drop it? Outside. Rain detected. Shit, 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 get back in. Get back in. Or is it stopped detecting rain now? Maybe it's stopped. Come on. Ah, dang it. This is why you quick save more often, kids. Because now I've got to drive this up again. And then carry the other safe across again. And all that gubs. Rain detected. Is that still not covered properly? Did I get lucky the first time I covered it? I mean, it's covered now, so that's fine. So, what have we got left? We've not done much with those bottom two yet, but let's go back and sort these two out that we know about. Right, so this is that safe, that little safe over here, and what if we just throw it through the floor? And it lands out here next to Big Truck. And it can go in Big Truck, I guess. If we can maneuver things properly. Now, get in my truck. Thank you. So those three are good to go. Those three can just be driven into the ocean somewhere near our boat. We've got a big heavy though, and we've got two others. And we've got two or three different vehicles that could help us out. I'm intrigued by that covered truck that we saw around the front here. I'm wondering if we can just blast the back off this truck. And then, yeah, that's perfect. Now we could fill this truck with goodies. Although whether or not we can get heavy safe in here is a question. Because I really want heavy safe in there, and then maybe the other two as well. Maybe starting with the other two would be more sensible, but heavy safe is close to us now. Let's make a hole. I'd like to be able to reverse this covered truck undercover. That's a lot of debris. This might take a moment. That tree is going to get in our way, isn't it? Or is it? No, bush will, but hey ho. Yeah. It's going to keep jackknifing, isn't it? Because I don't know how to truck. There we go, that's more or less what I was looking for. Ugh, shit. We broke off part of the roof of the truck, which is the last thing I wanted to happen. But not all of it, so could be worse. Right, so here we go. Old safe friend. Down drops to the next level. Good. Now, what am I blowing up here? Nothing important. Where is our truck parked? Over that way. So what if we bomb the floor over here? Is that going to give us access to the room? Yes. Come on, safe. I know it's a slog, but we can just about get you down here, I think. I was probably meant to use a crane for this. There we go. It's getting somewhere. There we go. And now we're down. Now we just need to get it into the back of the truck. Although we've broken some of the side of the truck as well.
A few inches later.
Maybe I should just hook this one up to a crane and then... Yeah, that might not be a bad idea. I don't want to spend the next half hour dragging this safe around just because of the sunk cost fallacy. Oh, I've got this far with it. I best finish the job. No, we'll just use a crane. Oh yeah, I should probably lower the crane arm if I'm going to do anything with it. Kind of parked big truck in a bad spot, but that's what you get for not planning anything in advance. Right, so now we could scoop up the hook here, plonk it on there. Have we got the safe? No, we've got some random rubbish. Now we've got the safe. Good. So is that safe now good to go? Maybe we can just drive it out. Yeah. We could probably get it further over though, couldn't we? Because you've got a bit of a grace period when it gets into the rain, so we could pull it back over here. Rain detected, you say? Nah, it's false alarm, mate. False alarm. And we're stuck on a bit of grass, because that's teardown. No, we're good. Just want to be cautious with it, like so. So now that one can just drive into the ocean, can't it? And then Big Truck can drive into the ocean. So let's line up Big Truck as well. Which means that... Oof. Bloody hell, Big Truck. We nearly got you again. Mad lad. So yeah, all that work backing covered truck into the building was unnecessary. Because we're going to actually use it for the other two safes, I think. And of course, yeah, we've actually got it beached anyway, so we're not using it for much of anything, really. Come on, you've got how many wheels? What are you even stuck on? Is it just the undergrowth? It's probably the undergrowth. Fuck it. We'll go and use a different truck then. Right, the fact that we've got plenty of room around this one means this one's pretty easy. This one's pretty straightforward. Because we can just grab the uncovered truck from over here, and then we can go ahead and back it into the building. Which means we can park the safe on it, cover it in planks, and then go about our business. That should be fine. Never seen a dryer safe in my life. But now we're going to have to go the long way because of my poor planning. The only sensible way to get this vehicle back up is to come around through the garage and then around the top. One of my planks is coming loose. Get back on top, Hugh. Thank you. Yep, my planks are all flapping. That one hasn't helped even a little bit. Sod it. Looks pretty damp to me, but the game's allowing it, so... Who am I to question it? Oh god, no it's not. It's having a fit. Maybe I'll transfer this safe to Big Truck. You got space for more, haven't you, Big Truck? Bit of a walk up the old plank. Yeah, look at that. So more or less, anyway, Covered Truck has done its job of delivering that one to there. But now it looks like some sort of weird plank Cthulhu, which is fine. It's fine. Fine with me, anyway. Oops. What are we stuck on now? It's fine. We're not stuck anymore. So where were you, final safe? You were on the other side of this wall. That bomb nearly killed us. But we live. Why would you design a safe anyway that's not waterproof? It's everything proof except water. Why would you build that? Doesn't really matter. I'm just curious. Now, let's get rid of some of these planks because they're just causing havoc. Yep. Glitchy planks. Not our friend. But the gun is great. I love the gun. Just for the precision of it. It's pretty amazing. Now, you park just there, please. And then planks. Is that going to be enough plank? Has that plank just made everything much worse? Looks like it has. Eh, it's probably fine. Okay, it's not fine. There goes the alarm. But we've got one down. Haven't really planned out a route as such at this point, but I mean, it's just drive forward and then jump out of the vehicle before they flop in the water, really. Blink, blink, blink. Yeah. It's the sign of me achieving things. Now, where's our boat? It's down this way. Might well be. That might be our boat over there. That's all the targets, and then it's a nice leisurely front crawl to get to old boat friend. Easy stuff. Ooh, now what's going on out here? What is all this? Is this corn? Is this from the fields? Oh yeah, we've done some harvesting. Lovely. I do appreciate the way our base is gradually improving over time. And although I hadn't picked up on it initially, it's also true of that green car that we keep damaging to test our new weapons, in that it's gradually being restored piece by piece. Look at it. We put another door on now. Working on the bonnet there, that's looking all right. That bit still needs sticking on somewhere, but I'm sure we'll figure it out. We got a new chair and cigars. Mix. Blend. Expensive food processor. Nice. Have we nicked one of those at any point? Maybe. Has Caitlin got any exciting news for us? Yet another break-in in the county, yep. Poor Gordon. Terrible, terrible shame. Clueless as to why they stole the safes. It's very unlikely they'll be able to open them. Yep. That's fair. So... yeah, he's clueless, basically. Who'd have thought it? Gordon Wu is clueless. New messages. So, we've got quite a few quests built up now. We've got this side mission to gather tools. We got this side mission to steal Gordon's cars again. We've got Lawrence Lee Jr. wants us to race around Gordon's racetrack, which I can't really be arsed with. And then... hello. Hello, hello. The Evertide Mall. Anton of Wolf Construction wants us to arrange for the food court to disappear. That sounds hella fun. Right, the insurance company aren't answering Gordon anymore. He's had it. He's going to destroy the power plant. So there we go. We've got a couple of missions. We've got a side mission that I'm absolutely doing because it looks like a destruction one. And they're hella fun. And then we've got a main mission where we go to Lee Chemicals again. He's going to provide us with the proper firepower to take out the main generator for good. Wow. Two fun missions coming up.